Welcome back, everybody, to FDB Regrowth. Okay, so from last episode, I realized I need to research something else, and that is the Infernal Furnace. Something you're going to have to do for the quest book. It's going to have to happen, so I went ahead and researched that. I got the discovery there. Give myself more warp. Thank you very much. Now, with that, with learning that, you get... No, you don't. The thing I was actually trying to achieve was arcane bellows, but I'm not entirely sure where they are hiding. Well, I didn't mean to click on that, but... Oh, well, we clicked on it. We learned it. Never mind. Arcane bellows. Is it on alchemy? Or do we actually... am I able to make this already? I don't know. Arcane bellows. No, I can't make that because I don't have the research. It's gotta be around here someplace. Arcane bellows. Where would you be hiding? I honestly thought the bellows were actually would be... here we are. Right here. So I did actually have to go through that. What did I need to... I just need an extra spot of motus. Okay, so I need three of them. One, two, three. Done. Good. Awesome. So, with those bellows, we're going to need a few bits and pieces, which I don't currently have. It's namely leather I don't have. Which is not hard to get, mind you. It's the usual stuff for either exchanging zombie flesh for leather or going killing a cow. I'd rather just use up the zombie flesh, to be quite honest. So go back over here. We'll take a couple pieces, why not? That is kind of a pain. Oh, never mind. Okay, we've got two pieces of leather. Fantastic. Now we go over here to our crafting table. Arcane bellows. Wood, air shard, leather. Okay. So we'll clear all this stuff out here. We'll just make the two up. Might as well. A piece of wood and the air shard itself. Now, air is definitely not that one. Is it ones across the top? Yes, it is. So I need two of those. So they're good. And we just need the wood. And hopefully I've got enough viz. Hopefully I do anyway. Yes, I do. Thankfully for that. Okay. So here's going to be the fun part. Do I have to connect the bellow up to that hopper? Now, if you know anything about the pipes, or basically Thorncraft pipes, pipes works on a system of suction. The alembic has a level of suction. The ascension buffer has a level of suction. Yes, these red bands here, they act as one-way valves. So if I have that unhooked up, well, basically not hooked up, anything if goes from the alembic into the buffer can go back into the buffer if the suction is not there. But if I put the one-way valve on, of the red, stuff gets sucked into the buffer, but it won't go back through. And this is what I need to achieve. And the jars themselves, they have a level of suction which is slightly higher than the alembic furnace. So you got to manage all that. So that's set up. Now, all I have to do is get some greatwood logs. So greatwood planks? No, has to be the logs. Or I could use the silverwood logs. Have I scanned those? Yes, I have. They actually have, they have a little bit more than I really want. So I'm actually going to cook up the greatwood logs here. I just need a spot of coal or something. Coal or something, or anything that will burn. Anything that will burn. I'd rather get coal, to be quite frank. Or charcoal or something you already do have, rather than like burning more of the wood. So I'll take the charcoal. Charcoal works for me. Okay, so shove that in there. That cooks up. So we get arbor plus potentia, and it's not going into the buffer. I can't remember why. Oh, maybe I've got the yeah. I think I've got these the wrong way around. There we go. There we go. Now I just need to make another buffer. I actually need to make several more buffers. To do that, I have to go back out and charge more ones again. So we'll be right back. Okay, well, after about half an hour of running around, it's going to be good once I get to a stage of actually having a wand great enough to start doing node jars, and then between episodes I'll just be like gathering nodes up to set up a master node for recharging things, and everything is going to be great. But we're not quite there yet. Soon, but not yet. Right, one wand, great. Another three more of those, fantastic. So then we stick that there, and we place that one there like such, and that'll sort that out, and we'll just place those other three there, and we'll do exactly the same. The system itself works really, really well. It's actually really nice. Now to get the thorium caps. I've got a really bad feeling there is a room that I need to set up which I haven't done as yet. And that is the infusion altar. Which is something that we have to make to get to basically do the caps. That's the inert. And, yep, I need to set up my infusion altar, which I haven't really done as yet. Which is kind of a little problem, just a little one. Now, if that's setting up there and I'm doing a staircase down, I might as well do a staircase up. Because the infusion altar is going to go up. So I suppose it's going to be a spot of building. Actually, I don't think I've actually really done any like straight building works in this playthrough as yet. I managed to pick up a few bits and pieces in my travels, but the things we go through. Oh well. Alright, let's get some stone stairs happening. So the stairs going down, we want stairs going up. Hopefully, it's not going to complicate things too much. Yep, still can go down. Fantastic. One more. Take the old Chatterer. And... okay. I might just install a window there. I'm thinking, yeah, probably. Well, that kind of works for me. Or either that, I just put some more smooth stone over the entrance. Or I could just put a window in. A window is actually sounding like a much better idea, to be quite honest. Just come here, maybe... have the landing out such this way. And yeah, we'll move in this way, like such. Because then I have to basically do another staircase. The idea is I want to try and get this infusion altar as far away as I possibly can from everything else. So it's isolated. So basically it's not being affected by other influencing things. Now, I think I am probably going to do a cut here. Do the rest of the staircase up to a point where I'm kind of happy with it. Or I could actually, how's the altar? I'll just have to see. Artifice. Infusion. Let's read the book, shall we, guys? Okay. Yep. Okay. It doesn't tell you much about the instability or the effect of other things on it. I'm just trying to remember what the range of instability is. So that is something I'm going to have to look at in between episodes. Yep. Not entirely a lot of progress, but... we have got the essential buffers working. We've got more than enough arbor, which... I'm just trying to remember. Can I just... No. There we go. I had to remember how that was done. You can actually just get rid of excess essential that you don't want. Just by like shift-clicking the jar. Or you could actually make the void jars. It's up to you. But void jars, I'm not quite in the position to actually make yet. But yeah, we'll get there. We'll get there indeed. Have a master crafting area here. Yeah, I can see it all now. Except it's going to take time. Definitely going to take time. Oh, well, guys, well, it's a bit of a shorter episode today. But, yeah, we've made some progress. We've got the buffers done. Got some stuff. I could just go ahead and make some of this stuff, but I really need to set up that altar. Okay, folks, well, thank you all for joining me for this kind of a brief episode. Sorry about that. And, of course, if you enjoy the series, do go ahead and click that like button for me. And, of course, if you feel inclined, go ahead and share my videos to Facebook, Twitter, whatever, wherever you go, whatever social circles you may travel in. Good grief. Okay, folks, well, I've been Raytech. I'll see you next time.